Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 113. Battlegrounds Mobile India is communicating with servers in China, reveals a new report. Krafton had earlier suggested that the data of Battlegrounds Mobile India players will not be sent to China servers. Battlegrounds Mobile India could risk getting banned in India again. Xiaomi made a new account on Weibo, a Chinese microblogging website, for a new department. The new unit in question is its very own movie studio, which has been dubbed as Xiaomi Studios. The new movie studio from the Chinese tech giant will aim on exploring content creation. In this announcement, the company also shared that it also be launching its Xiaomi Creator program on the social media platform. Smartphone camera performance have become increasingly more advanced with each passing year. So it seems like the company is bringing this to the forefront with the new studio to highlight its capabilities. Xiaomi has been selling smart TVs in India since 2018. However, the company doesn't offer a single accessory for any of its television. Over 3 years later, a Chinese tech giant is finally set to introduce the first accessory for its smart TVs in the form of Mi TV webcam. And Xiaomi has officially confirmed to launch Mi TV webcam in India on June 24. The upcoming Mi TV webcam will support full HD video streaming. The accessory will also sport dual far-field microphones with 3D noise reduction technology, and it will have a clip for sturdy grip and a camera shutter for privacy. And the remaining features include a USB Type-C port, magnetic clip for attachment, and support for Google Duo. But unfortunately, the compatible Mi TV and Redmi TV models are a mystery as of now. Xiaomi has confirmed that the new Mi TV 6 series of smart TVs would be launching on 28 June 2021. The company will be launching two flagship class TVs with a focus on video quality. If that's accurate, then they could both be OLED TVs. This is because OLED is currently considered the best quality panel when it comes to visual quality. Earlier this year, Xiaomi revived the Mix series with the launch of its first ever foldable smartphone. The company is reported to launch yet another Mix series device in the second half of 2021. Xiaomi Mix 4 codename of this handset has now been revealed as Odin by a leaker. Xiaomi will be upping the stakes soon in the accessories market by unveiling a fast charging devices that uses sound to charge smartphones and other electronic devices. This much can be gotten from the recent application for a patent filed by Chinese company at the China National Intellectual Property Administration. The filing reveals some essential details about the revolutionary charging system. The implications of this new technology when it finally debuts are pretty exciting. Although this innovative sound charging technology from Xiaomi could take years before it's become a reality, this filing indicates some level of progress in developing sound charging technology. The device will deploy sound and other components to provide power of charging smartphone and other devices. It will consisting of sound charging devices will be capable of collecting sound and energy storage apparatus and electronic devices. Samsung is all set for Galaxy Mobile World Congress virtual event on June 20th globally, where has confirmed that it will be showcasing how the Galaxy ecosystem of connected devices is set to provide people with even greater possibilities for enriching their lifestyles. It will also be unveiling its vision for the future of smartwatches at the event, with new opportunities for both developers and users designed to deliver a new era of smartwatches experience. Furthermore, understanding how device security has never been more important than it's nowadays, the company will be sharing its latest security enhancements and innovations designed to give users protection and peace of mind in an open and connected world. The Samsung Galaxy Mobile World Congress virtual event will be held on June 28th, live streamed on the Samsung YouTube channel at 7 p.m. CET, that is about 10:45 p.m. IST. Samsung Galaxy M32 price in India starts from 14,999 Indian rupees. The key specifications include a 6.4-inch AMOLED display, 90Hz refresh rate, MediaTek Helio G80 processor, and a 6000mAh battery. The Samsung Galaxy M32 price in India is set for ₹14,999 for the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage, and ₹16,999 Indian rupees for the 6GB RAM and 128GB model. It will be available in blue and black colors and will be on sale on Amazon, Samsung.com and key retail store across the country starting June 28th at 12 noon. As an introductory offer, the Samsung is offering an instant cashback of ₹1,250 when paid through ICICI cards. Samsung is gearing up for the Galaxy Foldable smartphone launch. According to the recent leak, the upcoming Galaxy Z Fold 3 will launch on August 3rd. Samsung will also unveil the clamshell Z Flip 3 alongside. According to the new reports, the Galaxy Z Fold 3 price could see a 20% drop compared to its predecessor. As per the new report, it states that Samsung is going to reduce the factory level price of its foldable in order to popularize the segment. Samsung Galaxy M21 Prime Edition could be launched in the Indian market as the Samsung Galaxy M21 2021 Edition instead. The smartphone has just shown up on the Google Play console list for supported devices. Samsung could launch the Galaxy M21 2021 Edition in India soon as the phone has already received BIS certification. According to the new report, early testing shows that AMD's custom RDNA 2 graphics processor for Samsung Next Exynos chipset is showing up to 30% faster than the current Mali G78 found in the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra with the Exynos 2100. If we take into account that the next generation Mali G710 promises a 20% in the performance, then the RDNA 2 powered Exynos chip would still offer better performance by about 10% more. LG has patented a new rollable OLED TV which features a side-rolling screen. While the company has showcased rollable television in the past, this TV is unique thanks to its dual side-rolling mechanic on its screen. The South Korean tech giant was awarded a design patent by the Hague International Design System. This patent was titled with the television with rollable display. In its rolled-up form, the television resembles the shape of its elongated speaker which has rounded sides. The device houses the display on either side that can be pulled out. When pulled out, the display unfurls out from the two housing units. WhatsApp's anticipated multi-device support will first arrive in beta on the WhatsApp web, desktop and portal clients ahead of its debut for users on Android and iPhone. According to the report, it would allow the instant messaging app to test the new development on a small group of users before bringing it to the masses. Multi-device support on WhatsApp has been a part of the rumor mill for some time. WhatsApp head Will Cathcart and Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg confirmed its existence in their reported conversation with a beta tracker earlier this month. Just last week, Spotify announced Green Room, its own version of Clubhouse. Now it is Facebook's turn as it rolls out its own version dubbed Live Audio Rooms, starting with the US alongside other audio tools and features. Live Audio Rooms begin rollout first as to test public figures and groups, but should be available to everyone by summer according to Facebook. There are about 1.8 billion people using groups every month, so these are those who will get it first, and public figures such as Russell Wilson and Olympic medalist Nastia Lyukin who get the features will also be available to host conversation with other public figures, experts and fans. Today, Infinix rolled out the first teaser of the mysterious handset that is equipped with blazing fast charging technology with a support for 160 watt charging. Infinix 160 watt fast charging technology allows users to charge a phone in less than 10 minutes. Hopefully, the company will soon confirm more details about its 160 watt charging solution. Realme's lifestyle brand Deezo will launch its first product on July 1st. Deezo products will be available on Flipkart Online, the company to launch smart entertainment, smart home, smart care and accessories. Realme seems to be working on a new G series phone as the Realme G1 has been listed on the company's official website. While the listing doesn't really mention anything about the phone, we can speculate it could be a budget offering placed just above the Realme C series. As per a new leak, TikTok has filed the trademark for TikTok. This application could be like a Clubhouse kind of application. Boat has launched the new true wireless earbuds, the Boat AirDrops 281 Pro in India today. The newly announced AirDrops 281 Pro were listed on Amazon last week. However, today the company has officially announced the pricing and availability details of these new true wireless earbuds. The AirDrops 281 Pro earbuds are equipped with 6mm drivers that they could use of Bluetooth 5.1 for the connectivity issues. These earbuds feature 4 mics, offer IPX5 certification and has ENX technology which delivers impeccable voice quality. Now let's check out the price and availability details. The Boat AirDrops 281 Pro comes in Active Black, Aqua Blue, Blue Flame and Viper Green and color options. These earbuds are currently available from Amazon for an introducing price of ₹1,999. Customers who pre-order the earbuds till June 25th through the prepaid payment method will get ₹200 cash back as an Amazon Pay balance. Vivo India has released a tweet that the Vivo V21 E5G will be launching on June 24th at 5 PM local time in India. The Vivo V21 E5G is likely to carry a pricing of ₹24,990 for the 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage edition. It is unclear whether the phone will come in another variant or not. Micromax M2C has been spotted on the Geekbench benchmarking platform. The key specifications include a Unisoc T610 processor, 4GB RAM and Android 11. Micromax M2C launch date in India could be announced soon. Joker malware has been found in 8 applications on Google Play Store. It reads your notification, calls, SMS and contacts and subscribes you to premium chargeable services. Google has removed these 8 applications from the Google Play Store. The 8 applications include Auxiliary Message, Fast Magic SMS, Free Cam Scanner, Super Message, Element Scanner, Go Messages, Travel Wallpapers and Super SMSs. Please don't install these applications for a while from now. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.